another day in the life. As I stepped on the block, pressure closing in closer, I saw a pole with my picture on a most wanted poster, accusing me of murder in an accurate quote. Oh, I get it, someone's trying to play a practical joke. Just as soon as I approached and started snatching it down, I got a call that said that they were plastered all over town. I said, I guess I better get somewhere and figure this out. This whole chain of events triggered more inquisitive doubt. I showed up at my girl's house that evening. She was steaming, mad, accusing me of sneaking out and scheming. Immediately told me I've been cheating, then pulled out a picture of me and the lady at a table eating. I vehemently refused to claim it, but looking at myself on the photo, it was hard to explain it. She tried to get a confession out of me, but it was obviously a doctor, the product of computer technology. I thought of explanations I could maybe explore, but in my heart I knew I'd never seen that lady before. Though I knew it wasn't me, I was confused and depleted. Snatched a picture out of hand, into the room I retreated. I laid across the bed, deep thinking and breathing. Am I dreaming? Is it real or is my sanity leaving? Newsman on the television tripled my load, speaking of a fugitive, but it was me that they showed. Now I'm questioning reality, I'm dazed and confused. First the poster, then the picture, now my face on the news. Went outside again and ran into my man on the block. Instead of dapping, he approached me with his hand on his Glock. He said, I see the real you was now revealed in that lash. You got the nerve to come around me after stealing my stash. I said, man, what you talking about? You gotta be sick. He said, how did you change clothes and hide the product so quick? It would have been impossible for you to jack and attack me on foot, then beat me back when I'm driving. I said, exactly. Something's going on, it wasn't me, man. I've been blamed for 4 stunts in a 3-hour span. He said, but it was you, same face, same height, slim. I said, well, let's go back to when you last saw me. I mean, let's just go. Please help me look for him. Before we even took a step, I looked behind me and saw him. Didn't have to chase him, he was coming in our direction. As I faced him, he mimicked my every move to perfection. He had replicated my physical down to the letter, and I'd have thought that it was me too if I didn't know better. I asked him of his purpose, when he said it, I knew it. A parallel universe opened up and he came through it. So you committed all those acts while wearing my shoes, but why me out of 6 billion others to choose? He said, why not? Out of 6 billion brains to test, a thorough analytic study proved that yours was the best. Everybody was impressed, and that included me too. I decided to come through your universe and be you. I told him I wasn't looking for a war in the least. I don't have a problem with you, man, I'm all about peace. It makes no sense to do evil under my image and name. You get the blame, he said, not after I altered their brains. I lunged out at him on the ground, we started to roll. When we separated, we were wearing identical clothes. Now my partner was confused, straight bewildered and froze. We both know the fake one goes once the real one is chose. When the people came, they knew that I had been framed. They saw two Carinos looking exactly the same. He knew everything that I knew or ever conceived, and told my mother if she picked the real one, he would leave. She looked in our eyes, then deep in our souls, said, I know my son anywhere, the fake is exposed. At that moment, a portal